vais vous parler d'une
espèce emblématique. The management of an emblematic species, a fascinating species, the red tuna. Why fascinating? Because it's a top predator. It's a huge fish, 3-4 meters, 500-600 kilos. Ever since Aristotle, it fascinated human beings. It travels across the seas, as you can see from this map. It can be present in northern Atlantic and the Mediterranean Sea, the Mexican Gulf, and also Nordic seas, Celtic Sea, Northern Sea, Norwegian Sea. It's a migrator. He travels a lot between the reproduction areas, especially Mediterranean and Gulf of Mexico. And he feeds in the northern seas, Iceland and Norway mainly.
Donc, c'est une espèce qui a fasciné et qui était
so this is a fascinating species, but also it's been exploited ever since antique times. The Romans with the Phoenicians had set up about 100 sites to catch red tuna all around the Mediterranean, also used in the Middle Ages where the tuna nets were set up. They are still in existence today. There are a few left in Sardinia and in Morocco. On this picture, you can see one of those sites, ancestral sites, before the tuna net. And you can see that there is integration. The fishes coming to the Mediterranean to reproduce are being caught. They are cooked and preserved in huge vats filled with olive oil and then exported all around the Mediterranean. So, typically here, this is sustainable, a sustainable exploitation. It went on for more than 2,000 years, but there have been variations across the centuries, also linked with environmental changes. The red tuna, over the 2,000 years, was not considered as a priced product. Everything's changed in the 80s with the emergence of the sushi sashimi market coming from Japan, and the red tuna became a product for which there was a high demand, which had an impact on fisheries in the Atlantic and around the Mediterranean in the 90s, especially in the beginning of early 2000, with a huge increase in the number of fishing boats, almost 1,000 fishing boats are catching red tuna in the Mediterranean, 250 of which are industrial ships. You see here, for instance, on top a rotating seiner, which is more what is used in Europe, and the bottom image is a longline fish which is used in the Asian seas. Tuna fishes can be fished in international waters by neighboring countries and also non-neighboring countries in international seas. So it's a shared resource, and when a resource is shared, it's very difficult to apply governance. Governance is left between the hands of an international body, SICTA, International Committee for the Conservation of Atlantic Tuna Fish, also protecting swordfish, for instance, and pelagic sharks. This international body, because it is a multilateral body, suffers from huge inertia and it does not really care for scientific opinions. This is illustrated by the picture showing that in light gray there is the scientific opinion, and the scientific opinion was for the annual quota of the species of 15,000 in recent years and 25,000 tons. But systematically, the committee recommended a quota higher than the scientific opinion. And more seriously, the fact that the committee never really implemented any monitoring on the fisheries catching red tuna. So no monitoring, no sanctions, and illegal fishing took off because the fish was in high demand, and we ended up with 50,000 tons being caught every year, which is three times what was recommended by the scientists. And because of these three ingredients, red tunas have been overexploited. This meant that there was a huge threat on the species, as identified by the scientific committee of SICTA, with the danger of population collapse. The civil society, therefore, became involved, and they started disseminating the opinion of the scientific committee, and this changed the perception of the public opinion on the danger, and politicians and decision-making bodies started taking decisions and started looking at scientific research and opinions. And in 2007, a reconstitution plan was implemented for the red tuna over several years. 2008-2009, it was reinforced every year with seasonal fishing, monitoring of the fisheries, monitoring agents climbing on board the fish, the ships. And finally, in 2009, a quota was imposed matching the scientific recommendation, 13,500 tons in 2009, much lower than the one recommended in 2007, which was 30,000 tons. So an effort has been made, thanks to the NGOs and the public opinion, and finally we see the result. Fishing mortality reached its lowest level in history in the 80s, and this means that the biomass increased quite strongly. And good news, finally, when something is done to manage a population in a drastic way, the trend can be reversed, and an overexploited species, an endangered species, can bounce back. But we still have uncertainties because it's not very easy to assess marine species, and there are dangers linked with the ICACT government's method, the multilateral body. There is the danger that the body will go back to previous governance methods which were not favorable for the management of red tuna.
De cette espèce.